The mystery of fast radio bursts is a relatively recent one. Before 2007, we didn't even know they existed. They come in the form of extremely powerful bursts of radio energy that tends to last fractions of a second, but in one case, they have been seen to repeat. That source is FRB121102, which continues to repeat and has been observed doing so dozens of times. This is of interest to SETI. Repeating radio signals are one of the things you'd look for in signals of intelligent alien origin, but in the case of the fast radio bursts, this is probably not the case, but can't yet be ruled out. While any sort of repeating signal is of immense interest, these are so powerful that they would be almost overkill for a civilization to use for communications. If this fast radio burst happened anywhere in the Milky Way, it would disrupt our communications very seriously. I suppose if aliens were sending signals to other civilizations in their galaxy, totally disrupting their communications with an extremely powerful repeating signal would get their attention. Thankfully, no such disruptive civilization seems to exist in this galaxy. FRB121102 originates in a small galaxy significantly smaller than the Milky Way, about 3 billion light years away. When these signals left that galaxy, life on Earth was still in its infancy. But the universe is far older than life on Earth, so it is possible, in terms of time, for an alien civilization to have arisen at that distance and built the technology to send a signal, though the apparent low metallicity of this galaxy on the whole would work against that. But why such a strong signal? That we see these signals so strongly at that distance, taken along with the probability that many of these things occur as apparent one-offs across the entire sky each day, tends to suggest that whatever causes them is some sort of natural cataclysm as opposed to anything artificial. But what natural cataclysms can repeat like this? We now have some vague ideas. In a paper by D. Michilli and colleagues, link below, they constrained down some of the environmental circumstances surrounding FRB121102. FRBs are typically difficult to study. They come in out of nowhere and tend not to repeat as FRB121102 does. As a result, they are difficult to pin down as far as origins go, but with FRB121102, the origins can be studied and pinned down, and what's been revealed is a highly unusual environment, to say the least. For one, the source must be small, only about 6 miles in diameter, and the signals themselves show evidence of having been distorted by a very dense, magnetically charged plasma field. The bursts also cluster in odd ways, and stranger still, they only appear in radio. When looked at in X-ray or gamma-ray frequencies, these things aren't there. The best fit here might be a neutron star or magnetar orbiting a black hole with an accretion disk, but as far as the actual mechanism of the bursts, it's an unknown. It's also unknown if all bursts are the same. Some may repeat, others may not, and the two may have completely different origins. All we can say for sure is that whatever is happening is extremely cataclysmic to produce that much energy. But the alien origin hypothesis is still on the table, though secondary to natural explanations and highly unlikely. But as a matter of speculation, it might be possible for an alien civilization to tweak a naturally occurring FRB to repeat, and then use that to get the attention of others on intergalactic scales. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier. Be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.